It is important to note that not everyone who has the disease eventually gets to the health facility for treatment.
Thank you. Wow.
Ni katika harakati za kukabiliana na maradhi ya kifua kikuu almaarufu TB. Ari yetu inatufikisha katika mtaa wa Kangemi hapa jijini Nairobi, wanapoishi na kuhudumu Steve Nguva na Joseph Thiong'o.
In 2009 April, I started having coughs, night sweats, chest pain. So I didn't know it's TB because I didn't have that information that TB comes this way. So I used to go to pharmacists around chemistry, take just the normal treatment without seeing any change. So I undertook medication for long. Anytime I feel not okay, I just go to a chemistry, then I take treatment.
Nilisikia vibaya mwezi ilikuwa mwezi wa sita last year. Ndio nikaenda kwa osi ya kanjo, nikaanza matibabu huko. Sasa nimekunywa dawa hadi sasa. Sasa nimemaliza, nikaa namaliza madawa.
Ni maradhi hatari sana. Hata hivyo juhudi za kukabiliana nayo zimeonyesha kuzaa matunda.
Kenya is considered one of the high burden TB countries in the world. And in the last 10 years we have treated about 1.4 million Kenyans for tuberculosis. The good news is that 90% of them have been treated successfully.
Imetukia mara nyingi maradhi haya kuhusishwa na ushirikina na laana.
So it reached a point whereby even my father, we live in a, my parents separated, so I live with my mother. So my father, where he was, he used to say, why can't we take this boy to prayers and let him recover? So they took me to some prayers, nothing was happening. They reached a point whereby he even brought some herbals to me so that they can clear those chest pain and coughs, but it wasn't working. So in July, the same year, 2009, it's when I discovered that, this cough has been so long. So I was coughing and then a friend of mine came around. Then the friend told me that, Steve, you might be having TB. Please go for free TB tests in a government facility. I went, told my mother that I have TB. My mother, the first thing she told me was like, that is not TB. Our family has never suffered TB. You have been cursed. Oh, it's where you've been going. Your father has brought in some witchcraft because of the separation. Oh, my father has the other wife. So they were telling me, my stepmother has brought the witchcraft, they want to kill us. So they are not going to allow me in the house and so on. So I used to stay with my friend.
Yeah, TB ni nini?
Well, tuberculosis is an infectious disease spread through the air, caused by a germ called Mycobacterium tuberculosis. When someone who has the disease coughs, sneezes, or talks, he puts the germs in the air. And if you are next to him, you will be able to breathe in the germs. And generally, the germs will go into your lungs. And for most people, you have an infection, but there is no disease. But in certain circumstances where, for example, your immunity of the disease or the body defenses against disease go down, then that infection can cause disease. Generally in this country, close to half of the population have actually the germs that cause tuberculosis in their bodies. But because their body defense or the body immunity is able to keep them intact, they do not suffer from the disease.
Ukosefu wa elimu bora kuhusiana na maradhi haya umekuwa kikwazo kikubwa katika kukabiliana nayo. Wanaoathirika wakiondokea kutengwa, kusalitiwa na hata kukanwa na familia zao.
But my mother told me yes, she will accompany me. On Monday in the morning she said no, we are not going to that Kangemi hospital. We are going to a private facility called Amat and do a chest x-ray so that the x-ray can tell us if it is TB. But we have never suffered TB in this family. So after doing the chest x-ray, the result came out to be TB. The same mama told me, you have to go to Kangemi for treatment. So my mother said she will take me. At around 11 that Monday, she brought me to Kangemi. Then we were counseled together and she was told the way she's supposed to support me in this condition. When we reached home, it was more stressful because she said, now you have been cast, we can't stay together. So she chased me home because I have TB. So I had to go and stay with a friend.
Lazima uone umetengwa juu kaa ni kwa pombe, wewe uendi, unaona sasa mabiste wa pombe hawa, amuko nao saa hiyo. Sasa lazima ukae peke yako juu, mabiste wengi ni wa pombe, wewe ukunywi pombe, unakuwa nikaa uko peke yako sasa.
Of course, there's a social cost. There's stigma associated with tuberculosis. People try, if you have tuberculosis, people will probably cut you off from their circles. That has an immense social cost to you as an individual or to your family. So tuberculosis is actually a socio-economic disease when you looked at it in that aspect.
Maradhi haya licha ya kunyonya nguvu zote za mwili, yasipotibiwa yanaambukiza na kuua kwa haraka sana. Dalili zake ni dhahiri.
I had lost a lot of weight because I was weighing around 35 kgs. I used to walk with another stick, supportive stick, because I was very weak. Even walking by myself was very hard.
Now, in the disease itself is manifested by you have a cough for more than 2 weeks, and in that cough you are producing something called sputum, which could have blood. You have chest pains. You have loss of appetite and you lose weight. You have night sweats. Generally, you feel fairly unwell. Tuberculosis mostly affects the lungs. In fact, about 80% of the cases of tuberculosis we report in this country and in many other countries affect the lungs. But also it can affect any other part of the body. And if it affects the lungs, it's called pulmonary tuberculosis. And if it affects any other part of the body, it's called extrapulmonary tuberculosis.
Ni katika kituo hichi cha magari hapa mtaani Kangemi anapohudumu Joseph. Na wito wake kwa wahudumu wenza ni kujitokeza kupimwa maradhi ya TB na wale ambao wanaugua kuhakikisha wanapata matibabu haraka iwezekanavyo.
Ningependa kuadvise watu wengine wale wako na TB, kama unakunywa madawa usichanganye na kitu kingine kama pombe, masigara, mabangi na madawa hivi za kulevya. Juu hata ukanywa madawa na unakunywa pombe huwezi pona. Hata ukasema umejificha sana ukunywa kapombe, na hapo ni mwili yako na hizo vitu zitakutana kwa mwili na utapona.
TB is treatable and curable. If you have a cough that has lasted for more than 2 weeks, you have weight loss, loss of appetite, you have chest pain, you are feeling generally unwell, please go for a test in your nearest health facility. If you are found to have tuberculosis, please take the drugs as has been prescribed by your healthcare provider. If you do that, you will be cured of the disease.
Ijapokuwa matibabu ya TB ni ghali mno, serikali imefanya tiba hii kuwa bure na inapatikana katika vituo vya afya.
Majority of the public health facilities, from dispensaries to health centers to hospitals, provide TB services. And our plan is to ensure that all of them be able to provide, so the services are much nearer to the people. So treatment is provided in close to 4,400 public health facilities, while diagnosis is provided in about 1,800 public health facilities. So the consideration is to ensure that these services are in each and every other facility. Furthermore, we work closely with faith-based organizations, but we also work with private organizations to ensure that many facilities have the service for diagnosis and treatment of TB, and the population can easily access them.
Naitwa David Matheri, na huu ni mchaka mchaka kukabiliana na maradhi ya kifua kikuu.